Right, today what I want to do is I'm going to go through with you some of the items I've made that I use when I'm to assist me when I'm skinning hides and things like that. You've seen me skinning hides and I use my knife and I do them on the floor in the kitchen or on the worktop and stuff like that. But other hides as well I also do outside, you know, stuff like deer and stuff like which are much bigger. So I'm going to show you what I've made and then I'll talk you through them. The first thing I've got is this tripod that's just made up of old pallets I got from work and a length of old drain pipe that I managed to find. And this is used when I'm defleshing the hides or dehairing them. And having this plastic being smooth, I mean you can see the marks on there where I've come off the edge with the draw knife, it's really, really effective. I mean you can see on the floor here, look, there's still some hair and stuff on the floor from other deers that I've done. And then what up behind here is this pole that's screwed into the wall in either end, and this is what I use for wringing the hides out on. I'm gonna say I've got all these ideas from a DVD, and what I'll do, I'll put a link up about the DVD where I got the ideas from. So that's, once you've had it soaked in the tanning solution, you put it onto this rack and use a stick. Where's my stick? So here's a strong stick, okay, it's just a short stick. And I use that to wring the hides out with. And you just twist it round and round and round and round and round, and you draw up as much water as you can as possible. So next time I get a decent hide, I'll go through it with you. And the last thing I want to share with you is my homemade draw knife. Okay, you can hopefully see that's made from a piece of angle iron. And then I've got some aluminium pipe which I've just gaffer taped on the other end. I've cut out this section here on the back, but left a very small piece of the angle there to give rigidity to it. And then I've ground on the bottom edge here. Okay, that's a flat grind. This one's a flat grind. And on the top there, that's a slight convex grind. And with this edge, it needs to have an edge, but it needs to be pretty dull. And you can see daylight coming off the end there, okay? Because you shouldn't be able to cut yourself on it. But it's actually cutting, it is sharp enough to, you can cut through the skin. If I sort of put the skin on there and just do that, it would cut through the skin. But I'm running my finger up here and it's not cutting me, okay? So you don't want a sharp knife, but you want a dull knife. If I'd have actually waited and looked around for it, I could have got this piece of steel. What's that, about 18 inches of piece of steel there. I'd have got that for nothing. You know, I was impatient, I wanted it last weekend. No, 2 weekends ago, sorry. So I bought it from B&Q. So a bit of a waste, but it cost me a fiver. But other than that, everything else you see here, my skinning post, the tripod, the pole at the back there, was all for free. The timber I got for the racking frame, or the stretching frame, sorry, I had to buy that timber, to be fair, because that's tantalised timber and that's going to be outside all the time. So I had to leave that out. I had to buy that. So I think in total I've spent in a region of £25, I think, for everything you see here. So